Okay, Gemini, let's see what's happening for your week. Transformation. Things are changing at a cellular level. Deep healing is happening for you, Gemini, this week. And I know when there's a lot of deep healing coming in, it's kind of like a little bit uncomfortable. We're not really sure what's up, what's down, where we're going. You know, it's just kind of like things are everywhere. It's kind of like when you clean your house and then you go, you know what? I'm going to declutter my drawers. And then all of a sudden, your house looks like a tornado because you decided to pull all the stuff out of your drawers out. But, you know, it looked clean before. But really, it's transformation because now you're making space for something else. So this is not about just tidying up and tucking it away, but really making space for you this week, Gemini. You have the number one activate card, awakening and enlightenment. This card is basically saying more transformation, the number one being that God number, allowing us to transform. This is the number of the beginning, the fool, the leap of faith. And these things are all entailed here. So it's basically saying it's activating within you. So what you're doing, continue to do it because this is why it's activating within you. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here. So you have been going through some transformations and you're doing the right things. I need you to know. Have faith in your dreams. Waxing crescent moon. Okay, your dreams are there for a reason. Dreaming is not pointless. But this is kind of like there's times for us to plant seeds with the dreams and then there's times for us to take action. So this is the time for you to plant seeds. Make a foundation, even if it's within yourself or if it's within on paper or if it's a vision board. But I feel like get this to be a very clear vision. That way you can manifest it with ease. And the universe wants to help you with that. Dare to be different with the hyena card, Gemini. Allow yourself to flow with you. When we talk about innovation, innovation is not copying what somebody else did. It's about creating a path. And it might be a more arduous path. But guess what? You did it for yourself. And this is super important. Because this is where your confidence is going to be coming from, because you are capable of doing this on your own, with your own vigor, with your own ideas. All right, let's see what you have for ancestors. Eagle, see from a higher perspective, all right? And I feel like Eagle's saying, trust the process. Fly high, trust the process. Even though crows might be able to fly up here and they want to attack me, the eagle, guess what? I can still fly higher than them, and then they won't be able to breathe, and they'll just fall down. Okay, so look at things from a detached perspective, the bigger picture. You're thinking too small. Let those dreams be as big as the room, as big as the sky, as big as the ocean. Okay, there's no dream that is too big. As long as you focus on it and you believe in yourself and trust the process, it will come into fruition. You have Angel Faith blessing you with freedom this week. And then you have Angel Sarah blessing you with empowerment this week. These are energies that are coming into your field. So make sure that you are claiming them so that they can be expedited right into your field this week, Gemini. And I hope that serves you. And in addition to that, Gemini, I feel a lot of energy coming down again for you. There's some, not every sign gets a lot of energy every week. There's like one or two signs that I'll get like an additional wave of energy. And that's kind of like saying, hey, we're giving you an extra push. So make sure that you're claiming what it is that you need to claim, because we're very prevalent around you.